Roger Waters is best known for the band member, lyric writer, and leader of Pink Floyd. Also, he is the mastermind behind the third best-selling album of all time, The Dark Side of the Moon. Roger Waters had become the lyricist, bass player, and leader of Pink Floyd. He was born in Surrey, year 1943, and grew up in Cambridge, England. Roger Waters attended the same school as his Pink Floyd band members, David Gilmour and Syd Barrett. But he had met Nick Mason and Richard Wright while attending Regent Street Polytechnic School of Architecture. Aside from his interest in music, he had also shown interest in sports, especially swimming. Waters discovered Pink Floyd along with his friend Syd Barrett. During the late 60s, it was Syd who did most of the song writing for the band, but Roger did write the lyrics to Take Up Thy Stethoscope and Walk for the album Piper at the Gates of Dawn, Roger's full leadership of the band. When Syd Barrett's disastrous mental health had led him to leave the Pink Floyd, Roger Waters sat in the driving seat and took hold of the band's leadership. The direction of the band was now in Roger's hands. Since then, Roger Waters' lyrics and ideas went into the most successful Floyd albums such as Dark Side of the Moon, Wish You Were Here, Animals, and The Wall. Without Roger's skillful talent put into these albums, Pink Floyd would be where they are today. Roger Waters' contribution to the band can be difficult to recognize, because he cannot be heard musically on the Floyd records, being that David Gilmour is the main lyricist and provides a lot of the sounds through his guitar. It is very much the opposite. Roger is the most creative member behind the band with his great talent of concepts, ideas, and lyrics. Many say that Roger Waters is Pink Floyd. I wouldn't disagree. But so is David Gilmour. Roger's father, Eric Waters, had fought and died in World War II in Anzio in 1944. Roger was only a year old. This had inspired him to write some of his music with Pink Floyd and his solo work. This includes part of The Wall, The Final Cut, and his own album Amused to Death. Roger Waters' career ended with Pink Floyd from the 1980s. Roger started to have his differences with the band. He and David Gilmour would argue about each other's opinions, and at the time of creating The Wall, he sacked Richard Wright from the band. Moving on towards the early 80s, Roger Waters had left the band following The Final Cut. After that, he demanded that Pink Floyd would end. The existing members such as David Gilmour and Nick Mason battled against Roger's decision. Roger Waters failed to take away the band name Pink Floyd from the remaining. However, he did win the right for The Wall. Roger Waters' solo career. After the end of Roger's time with Pink Floyd, he kicked off his solo career releasing three albums that weren't as near as the success of his Pink Floyd albums. His albums in order are The Pros and Cons of Hitchhiking, 1984, About a Man's Dream in a Particular Night. This was supposed to be Pink Floyd's next album, but did not get released due to the band's breakup. Radio K.A.O.S. was released in 1987, with the album being based upon a boy hearing radio waves in his head, I presume in war. Thirdly, Amused to Death was released in 1992, which was to be his most successful selling solo album. These albums are actually quite cheap to buy. Please feel free click on them to find out. In Roger's new generation, he moved into opera and released a French album called C.A. Ira in 2005. He also did a concert in Paris later on to promote this album. Roger's live concerts and tours. Roger Waters performed a live tour called In the Flesh, in which he performed both Pink Floyd and solo material. The tour started in 1999. And had lasted 3 years, and there was a DVD released called In the Flesh Live, because the tour was so successful. This DVD is taken from one of the best concerts of the tour. It features both Roger Waters solo and Pink Floyd music. I bought my copy and I watched it over and over and over again, because the sound, quality and music are simply fantastic. The song Dogs is just amazing. I would have paid double the price of this DVD. It is a must for any Floyd or rock fans. In 1990, Roger Waters also entertained a live show of The Wall in Berlin just after the Berlin Wall was taken down. This concert was performed in front of 250,000 fans and was one of the biggest live shows ever. Roger Waters invited famous guests to perform the songs. These guests such as Jur Lauper, Bryan Adams, Paul Carrack, Van Morrison and more. just when you thought that Roger had really despised the other members of Pink Floyd and claimed that they have ran away with his music, in July 6, 2005 Roger Waters performed with Pink Floyd at Live Aid in Hyde Park to perform four songs and left his hatred behind. During the performance of Wish You Were Here, Roger said, "It's actually quite emotional standing up here with these three guys after all these years. Standing to be counted with the rest of you. Anyway, we're doing this for everyone who's not here, but particularly, of course, for Sid."